Hello, and welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be reading a story from Disney's Scary Storybook Collection. Today we're going to be reading a story from Disney and Pixar's Toy Story called Toy Story of Terror. It was a dark and spooky night. A woman was being chased through a cemetery by a vampire. The vampire was getting closer and closer. Suddenly, someone screamed. "Run, Betsy, run!" Rex called out. Bonnie and her family were in the car on their way to a family vacation. Bonnie's toys were in the trunk of the car, watching a scary movie. "Boring," Mr. Potato Head grumbled. "Patience," Mr. Prickle Pants advised. "All great horror films start slowly." Mr. Prickle Pants was an expert on scary movies. In fact, he considered himself an expert on all movies, and plays, and books. Inside the car, Bonnie rubbed her eyes. "Are we there yet?" she asked with a yawn. "Not for a few more hours," her mom replied. "You can go back to sleep." Ka-thump! Just then, the car hit a pothole and blew a tire. The toys went flying. Jessie fell into a toolbox, and the lid slammed shut. "Help!" she screamed. Woody and Buzz Lightyear jumped into action. The two forced open the box and helped Jessie climb out. Jessie was frightened. "I couldn't find a way out," she said, gasping. "What's the matter with Jessie?" Trixie whispered. "She was abandoned in a box for years," Mr. Potato Head explained. Outside, thunder boomed and lightning flashed. The storm was getting worse. Bonnie's mom pulled over to a roadside motel. The family would be staying there until the tire on their car was fixed. Bonnie reached into the trunk and grabbed her toys. A roadside motel is one of the most common locales for a horror film, Mr. Prickle Pants pointed out when they reached their room. Mr. Potato Head decided to go look around. "I wouldn't go out there if I were you," Mr. Prickle Pants warned. "The first to leave usually gets it." Mr. Potato Head scoffed. He wasn't worried. The toys went after Mr. Potato Head, but he had vanished. "Maybe this place is haunted," Mr. Prickle Pants whispered. The toys split up to look for Mr. Potato Head. Suddenly, Rex screamed. "Ew! I stepped in something," he said, trying to wipe a mysterious goo off his foot. As Buzz looked around, he realized that Mr. Potato Head had stepped in the same stuff. He had left a trail of footprints. Trixie followed the tracks to an air vent. As she looked down, she fell in and disappeared. "Once the heroes enter, there's no turning back," Mr. Prickle Pants noted. The toys followed Trixie into the vent, Buzz's glow-in-the-dark features lighting the way. "What happens now?" Rex asked Mr. Prickle Pants. This would be the part where the characters get separated and then picked off one by one, answered the hedgehog. Seconds later, something snatched Mr. Prickle Pants. Then it snatched Rex. Woody, Jessie, and Buzz looked at each other and ran. Just then, something slowly crept out of the darkness towards them. It was Mr. Potato Head's arm. "It's trying to tell us something," Buzz said. "It's the number one," Woody said. "I think maybe it's pointing up," Jessie said. Above the toys was a vent. The trio followed it to a bathroom. As Jessie looked around, something snatched Woody and Buzz. Then something pulled Jessie under the sink. It was Combat Carl, a soldier toy with a missing hand. "This place isn't safe for toys," he warned. The pair heard a noise. "We're trapped," Jessie cried. "Combat Carl never gives up," the soldier toy said. "Combat Carl finds a way." The toys tried to run, but something snatched Combat Carl. Jessie was on her own. The cowgirl hid in the bathtub. Seconds later, she heard a loud rip. Claw slashed at the shower curtain. As Jessie backed up, an iguana appeared. It had Mr. Potato Head's arm in its mouth. Jessie prepared for the worst, but the iguana was actually friendly. It swallowed the arm in one gulp and then gave Jessie a big lick. Grabbing her gently in its mouth, the iguana carried the cowgirl to a room behind the motel's lobby. He sat her in a basket and rang a bell. Ding! "Excellent find, Mr. Jones," the manager said, coming into the back room. He had trained his pet iguana to steal toys from motel guests so he could sell them on the internet. The manager posted Jessie's picture on a website and put her in a glass cabinet. The cowgirl's friends were there too, even Combat Carl and his friend, Junior Combat Carl. A few minutes later, the manager returned. He checked his computer. He had sold Woody! Reaching into the cabinet, he grabbed the cowboy and packed him in a box. A delivery truck would be arriving soon to pick up the package. "Woody!" Jessie whispered sadly. "What started out as a classic horror film has turned into something more of a tragedy," Mr. Prickle Pants observed. A few minutes later, the manager sold Jessie too. He had just taken her out when the mechanic arrived to fix Bonnie's car. The manager put Jesse down and went to speak with the mechanic. Jesse tried to unlock the cabinet, but she couldn't reach the latch. Even worse, the delivery truck had arrived. The driver came into the back room and took the package with Woody inside. Jesse didn't know what to do, but Combat Carl had a plan. "Listen," he said, "in a few minutes, the delivery lady is going to come through the door and take the other boxes, and you're going to be in one of them." Jesse panicked. "I can't get into a box," she said. "Jesse," the soldier shouted. When Combat Carl gets stuck in a jam, he says to himself, "Combat Carl never gives up. Combat Carl finds a way. Now say it," he ordered. Jesse tried. "Combat Carl never gives up. Combat Carl..." "You're not Combat Carl," he shouted at her. "Oh, Jesse never gives up. Jesse finds a way," the cowgirl repeated, finally understanding. Jesse snuck into the empty lobby, opening one of the boxes the manager had packed. She freed a robot toy. Bravely, Jesse crawled into the box in the robot's place. If she could get on the delivery truck, she could free Woody. The plan was working, until the delivery lady taped the box shut and threw it in the truck. Jesse began to panic. Then she remembered Combat Carl's words. "Jesse never gives up. Jesse finds a way," she told herself. Feeling around, the cowgirl found a paperclip. She used it to slip the tape and crawl out of the box. Then Jesse found Woody. The two returned back to the room to free their friends. Suddenly, Jesse heard Bonnie's voice coming out of the lobby. The car was fixed. Bonnie's family was getting ready to leave. The cowgirl raced towards the curtain and separated the back room from the lobby.
She was almost there when Mr. Jones caught her.
Jesse kicked the iguana and it split something out. "My hand," Combat Carl shouted from inside the cabinet. Mr. Potato Head's arm was also inside the iguana's mouth. Jesse grabbed the arm and used it to pull the curtain open. At that moment, Bonnie looked through the curtain and saw the cabinet. "My toys," she cried, running into the back room. "Are those my daughter's toys?" Bonnie's mom asked the nervous motel manager. Meanwhile, Mr. Jones put Jesse in a basket on the floor and rang the bell. Looking down, Bonnie saw the cowgirl. "Jesse!" the little girl shouted, pointing at her doll. Later, back in the trunk of Bonnie's car, the toys celebrated. "You did it, Jesse. You saved us all," Buzz said. "Jesse didn't give up. Jesse found a way," the cowgirl said. Mr. Potato Head looked fondly at his arm. "We ain't never gonna get separated again," he said. Ka-thump! Just then, the car hit a bump. Mr. Potato Head's parts scattered around the truck. "Aw, nuts," he said. Everyone laughed. And that, Mr. Prickle Pence noted, was a sure sign that the story had reached its end. Thank you so much for listening. I'll see you guys next time. Have a spectacular night. Bye.